My name is Andy Koman, and I'm the professor and chair of orthopedics at Wake Forest Baptist Health. My clinical specialties are in hand surgery and pediatric orthopedics. Within hand surgery, I do vascular problems, congenital problems, nerve problems, including the brachial plexus, and chronic pain. I became an orthopedic surgeon because I liked the variety of things that you could do and that you could help patients and see the results fairly quickly. We can eliminate pain or most of pain in patients with arthritis. We can correct significant deformity in children with congenital abnormalities. We can make patients who have difficulty walking either able to walk or to walk better. And I like a lot about it, the fact that orthopedic surgery is not just surgery. We really do lots of non-operative care and lots of rehab, which led us to develop non-operative care treatment patterns. One of the things that I'm very pleased that we've been able to do at Wake Forest, and we were actually the first place in the United States, actually in the world, to do that, was to use botulinum toxins to decrease spasticity in children with cerebral palsy and adults with cerebral palsy, to use botulinum toxins to make recovery from surgery better, that we were able to develop techniques to decrease pain associated with abnormal blood flow and to restore blood flow in children and adults with abnormal blood vessels or problems. We're also very fortunate that orthopedics at Wake Forest Baptist Health has every subspecialty in orthopedics. And there are actually 7 subspecialties within orthopedic surgery. If you count shoulder and elbow as a separate one, there are actually 8. And we have multi-layers of support in each one of those. So we have almost 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, subspecialty care in all of the specialized treatment areas within orthopedic surgery. And that's fairly unique. There are not many places that can do that. And of course, that takes a large faculty. We have 30 surgeons. And a half a dozen non-operative physicians that allow us to provide that service. We also provide, and we're the only actually medical center in North Carolina that has never closed to trauma in the 30 years that I've been here. We've never been full. We've always taken patients and not transferred them to other level 1 trauma centers.